I've been thinking for a long time about the various stages of my life, childhood, teenage years, my 20s, 30s, my 40s and 50s, and now my 60s. All of my life can be measured, not quite as T.S. Eliot said, in coffee spoons, but in fragments and actions. I can speak of the years that I lived at home when I was very young, or the 2 years I lived in Los Angeles when I went to the University of California and realized I didn't want to study and I didn't want to work in the movie industry. And then a couple of years of floundering around trying to figure out what the hell I wanted to do. And then my 3 years in Washington, D.C. when I came off the California beach and moved back east and saw the other side of America. And then I came back to California and worked here and worked there, and in my 30s went back to the university, the University of California, where I studied literature and Spanish and filmmaking, once again, filmmaking and video, and realized once again I didn't quite fit in with the Hollywood industry, and yet I had some bones to pick with the independent, aesthetic, intellectual, artistic community. I wanted to go my own way. And so I buried myself in silence, went back to working for offices, eventually back with the city of San Diego where I had worked before. I had a dream, sort of becoming a typist for the highest levels of city government. And I was fortunate enough to achieve that dream, to where I was writing and typing and publishing and distributing memoranda and reports and letters for the city manager. And then even that, I realized, was not what I wanted. And I left the city of San Diego and eventually followed another old dream. I ran away to Mexico. I lived in Tijuana for almost 10 years. And there I began to translate and to publish my poetry. After 9 years or so, I came back to San Diego because my stepfather had died and my mother asked me to come help her keep the house here where I am. You see all those books? This is in her house. And I began to work about the same time more and more on movies and video. Not just poetry, but visual filmmaking, which had always attracted me, but I'd never done much of it until finally, with computers and the internet, filmmaking became very inexpensive. And yet, as one man said to me in a video computer store about 10 years ago now, if you don't have any talent, it doesn't matter how savvy you are technically. And that's always been the struggle, to balance myself between inspiration, talent, skill, and technical prowess. So here I am, 15 years into the third millennium, and I'm still alive, still writing poems, and now making movies.